guys, how's it going? Welcome back. Today is a fantastic day. I'll tell you why. Right now, I'm on the highway, and I'm heading out to the Nopiming again. So, this video is actually my 1 year anniversary video of being on YouTube, which, you know what, is pretty freaking exciting. So to anybody that's been following me since the beginning, you'll remember my first video. My first video I ever posted, and you can actually go back and look, was a fall grouse hunt at the Nopiming, and it was actually my best grouse hunt that I've ever had. So I'm hoping to rekindle that magic. Now, if you have been with me since the beginning, I want you to write down in the comments that you've been a loyal subscriber since day one. I want to know who you are. I have an inkling of a couple people, you know, a couple of my close friends and stuff like that have been watching every single video that I put on. But if you're just somebody I didn't really know before this, I would like to know that. So anyways, this year I'm going to do things a little bit differently. I'm not just going to go after grouse. I am going to do a little bit of fishing as well, but I'm also going to make it a little bit of a challenge. So my goal this weekend is to do a 48-hour survival challenge. Now, I know, don't get me wrong, I could just not eat and I'll be totally fine. And I know a lot of people say, yeah, Mark, you got a lot of reserves, so you'll be fine. But my goal is not just to starve myself, is I actually want to thrive out there. So I'm hoping to be able to, like, I didn't even bring any food. The only thing I brought was some butter and some spices. So again, no food. So what my plan is when I get out there, there's a lake that I'm pretty confident I'll catch a fish pretty quickly. So if I can get a couple bass tonight, or even a pike or a walleye, I'll have supper for tonight, and I will hopefully have breakfast. And then tomorrow, we're gonna do a big grouse hunt. You know, I'm hoping to log in 15 kilometers. Hoping to limit out. That'd be honestly the best thing ever. I've yet to limit out, and maybe Saturday night have a wicked little surf and turf. So yeah, like I said, I'm probably a couple hours away from the Nopiming, so when we get into the park, I'll get all set up by the lake that I'm going to, because basically by the time I get out there, I think I have about an hour and a half before sunset. I'm hoping to get a couple fish. I'm going to set up my camp. I'm not sleeping under a tarp tonight. I didn't bring my camper or anything like that, but I did bring my ice fishing shack, like my little pop-up tent. And I'm going to have my wood stove, so it will be a very, very comfortable night. Now, the other thing, too, is I also brought papier along. So, I ended up cleaning out one of his 30-odd six shells and putting his ashes in. So, now I can bring him everywhere with me. The only thing I need to do is make a really nice chain for this. But that'll be another project. So, yeah. Let's hope I don't start. Oh, and I also brought my boat because I want to get a grouse with the boat. That's also another one of my goals. But first, I'm going to get a couple grouse so I'm not with my 22. And then we'll focus on that challenge. So, yeah. We'll see you guys in the Nopiming. And I don't know. I'm just happy right now. I'm happy to get out of that stinking city. And this is hopefully going to be my last weekend that I really need to clear my mind with everything that's happened to my grandfather and stuff. So hoping for after this weekend I can just get back to my normal life and everything's going to be tickety-boo. So anyways, see you guys at the park. Woo! So I've arrived at the lake that I'm going to be fishing at. Unfortunately, it's starting to rain, but I need food, so it is what it is. Hope it doesn't rain too hard, because I'd rather not get soaked. But if it gets soaked, I guess we'll just have to make a nice fire and dry off. Alright, so let's head in there and try to catch a couple fish. Well,
Got my first fish. I definitely wouldn't say this one's a keeper, unfortunately, though. You're lucky. You're not bigger, buddy.
So yeah, I fished for about 45 minutes or so. That didn't really pan out, so I made an executive decision to go and try to locate a grouse quickly, so I could at least eat something tonight. I did see three. I shot at one and missed, unfortunately. Yeah, that was my bad. Of course, when my stomach was grumbling. But I walked a couple more roads. Didn't see any grouse, but I did get two chipmunks. I mean, at least I'm eating something tonight. Tomorrow, I'm going to go hit the grouse pretty hard. And maybe, because it's supposed to be pretty nice day tomorrow, get a little bit warm, especially even Sunday. Sunday might even be a better day. And then I'm going to go hit those shallows again for those bass, because I think the bass will be up there more. Right now, it's been raining the whole time I've been out here, and a lot of cooler temperatures, so I'm thinking they move back into the lake a little bit, but I'm not sure. But yeah, anyways, so I'll show you guys around here. This is a pretty sweet little setup I got here. So I got the ice fishing tent out, right? So there we go. There's that propane tank wood stove that I built last winter. It's actually, it's made in Voyage out in the bush, so pretty excited. There's that stove jack that I built as well. I'm going to link those videos down in the description if you haven't watched it. And, but yeah, pretty wicked getting to use something that I built myself. This is so much better than that 50... cal ammo can that I built. Like, that little ammo can is pretty awesome if you want to tend it all. I mean, this thing, I can regulate the temperature way better. Yeah, way better. Like, look at this thing. Beautiful door. I sealed it real nice. I even put, you know, the dampener in there. Nice big stove pipe. Like, yeah, this thing is pimp. But yeah. My wood pile for the night, anyways. Like I said, it's still raining outside a little bit, so I'm hoping that rain doesn't conceal the night. I did put a tarp over this because ice fishing shacks can leak pretty good if they get too wet. So, I haven't got my bed set up yet, but I did bring my cot, so it'll be really comfy sleep. Like, super comfy. Probably gonna have to have the doors partially open. It is pretty warm in here. So, anyways. I just want to wish Papeo a happy birthday. I know you didn't get to make it to this one, but I'm out here celebrating for you. I even have you, you know. You're on this adventure with me, so yeah. Happy birthday, and yeah, I'll see you guys in the morning. And hopefully get into some grouse, maybe a couple fish.
Good morning, guys. How's it going? So, it's about 7:30 in the morning. I'm going to head out. I'm going to go find some breakfast. Pretty hungry. It rained a good chunk of the night last night, but I stayed nice and dry, nice and warm. I'll definitely show you guys camp a little bit better later on. Right now, we're going to go find a couple grouse and try to get some food inside of me. All right. Yes. Well, we got breakfast. Frickin' rights. So stoked. Just came around this corner. Two grouse sitting right there. Got them. Whew. Oh, that feels good. No more starving. Yes. Yes. So I got three roughies down now. Nice roughy. That's awesome. That was freaking awesome. That one I heard fucking grouse calling. So I came to investigate. There he was sitting right here on this log. So I think I've been out here for about an hour and I got four roughies already. I'm almost limited out. So I think I'm just gonna keep hunting, try to limit out, go back to camp, make a hell of a good meal, and then let's go fishing for the day. Yes! Come on, number five.
Look at that, guys, a big fucking bull moose. Sack.
Well, guys, back at camp. So it's about, I think 10 after 10. We got five grouse. So I didn't limit out. I probably could have, but I'm pretty hungry. So I got a fire going. And we're just gonna get those cleaned up. Gonna get put those in the fire. They're gonna taste real good. And then I also picked up a couple birch bullets. So never ate a wild mushroom, but I'm 100% confident in these ones. So I'm gonna cut those up and I'm gonna throw them in with the grouse, and we're gonna see how they taste. And yeah, pretty excited. Well, there she is. I'm gonna try one of these mushrooms out, but I've never. This mushy thing right here is a mushroom. Well, that's good. Real good. That's good. So, basically, about 11 o'clock now. So, I'm allowed one more grouse today. So, for right now, I'm definitely not, I'm not gonna go after grouse right now.
I do have this little lake behind me. Seems a little shallow. I don't know what exactly I'm going to find in there. But I think instead of driving around and going up, I may even try Beresford after. But there's a nice little point over there. So we're going to try to hike in to that point and just cast and see what we find. Maybe we can find a little pike. I'm sure there's a pike or something in here, or at least a bass, or who knows. But yeah, I'm going to chill out a little bit. I'm going to have a beer. I'm going to enjoy this food. And we're going to continue on with our day. Really, life doesn't get much better than this.
There's a lot of geese up there, holy cow. That's like the fourth squirrel I found with the mushroom in its mouth. I guess squirrels like mushrooms too.
Look at these moose tracks. Huge. Sick.
Oh yeah. Definitely a calf. A cow and a bull.
Sick.
The other bull I just saw not that long ago was huge. Absolutely huge. Such cool animals. I have no idea if that's how you call moose. Good morning, guys. So, final day, final meal, couple grouse breasts. And starting to pack up. So I know I haven't shown you guys yet, so let's take a look. So this is the spot that I found. It's kind of like I found it last year hunting. Obviously people have used it for camping. It's kind of off the main road, but you really got to know where you're at. There's a nice little lake here. Honestly didn't even try to fish it. Yesterday I just relaxed in the afternoon and I went down to a shoe lake just because I know that lake and I just want to kind of go for a drive. But yeah, it's definitely beautiful out here, that is for sure. So there is another, it's almost like a marsh kind of in that area. Lots of ducks and geese, and I think what I heard last night were some swans, or it's definitely a noise I heard. So here's the where I'm set up. Now, very, very comfortable. So you can see It's my wood stove. There's my cot. So for me, that was absolutely perfect. This is kind of like a portable little cabin for me. Anyways, I'm just gonna do up some breakfast here. And then we're gonna start heading back home. But I'm gonna hit some bush roads. We're gonna try to fill a limit of grouse to bring home. That'd be nice. Even a few more. But all in all, I think my 48-hour survival challenge panned out. I mean, could I say I'm a little hungry? Maybe. But you know what? I didn't starve. And one thing I do have to say is I'm just ecstatic. Compared to last year, last year I was 277 pounds at this time. So if you guys even remember that the winter camping trip I did, just killed me. Absolutely killed me. Well, now I'm down to about 253 and just feeling awesome. So yesterday put another, I think it was 11K. And, you know, I hand bucked all my firewood. No problem. I have even more firewood than I did last time because I ran my outside fire and my wood stove in there. So I'm feeling great, feeling absolutely great, and that's a great feeling. So yeah, gonna make some breakfast, we're gonna hit the road, hopefully we'll get a couple more grouse.
Brucey's, what's up?
So yeah, yesterday was all roughies. Started the day with two spruceys. Frickin' rights. Grouse video, I did show you guys how to field dress the grouse. One thing I didn't show you guys, and actually it's one of my favorite parts of the grouse, and it's the gizzards. So this is the stomach of the grouse, and this is all really good meat. So I'll show you guys how to clean this up. So all I do is I take my knife and I slice it open, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna peel her open. You're going to see, usually filled with grass, pine needles. Actually, yeah, it smells like pine needles in this one. And gravel. Lots and lots of gravel. They actually, that's why you find them by the bush roads quite a bit. It's because they go there to get some gravel. It helps break up the pine needles. So, but now one thing inside here, you're not done yet. So there's a really thick, inner stomach layer, and all you do, grab the corner And you start peeling that right off. There you go, that part right there, that's gone. Now all you do, clean that up, and you got yourself, that's a really, really good piece of meat right there. Well, I have one more road that I'm gonna go down, and then I'm just gonna head home. It's been pretty awesome. I definitely needed this weekend. Like I said, it was Papa's birthday on Friday, and tomorrow's my birthday, so this was a great way for me to spend our birthdays. So far, I got 7 grouse, so can't really complain at all. Didn't get any fish, well, except a little bit. I didn't really try to fish all that much. My goal out here wasn't to fish, was mainly to hunt. So I'm pretty happy bringing some food back for Olivia. So unless I run into like some more grouse or something like that, I'm just going to end it right here. So if you like this content, don't forget to hit that like button at the bottom. And if you're new to this channel, check out the rest of my stuff. If you like my content, feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.